Today, I would like to pick up another more interesting type of reaction in this session, oxidation and reduction reaction. This oxidation and reduction reaction occurs in our daily life. I want to cite one example. When you see your banana, your ripe banana, after 4 or 5 days, it starts blackening at the cover. How is it happened? That means the oxidation reaction takes place. That is also an example of the oxidation reaction happened in the fruits. And another one more example also, that fruits, when you cut your fruits and care for apples, when you cut your apples and care for 2 3 hours, then the fresh surface start changing somewhat, color change like brownish color, and that is also an example of oxidation happens. That means you expose it in the air, and that's why oxidation reaction happens, and the surface of your cut fruits changes. That is also a example. And another one more very interesting example is your foot that we eat, they digest. In the sense, you are saying that it digests, but actually, it is happening an oxidation reaction. In your biology, you have discussed about the term respiration. So, in respiration, what happens? The glucose present in the food, they break down in presence of oxygen. That means they combined with oxygen, they combined with oxygen and converts into carbon dioxide, water, and energy. So that is also a very good example of oxidation reaction. So all from this example, you may try to know that what would be an oxidation reaction. Very simple. Oxidation reaction is just a combination. An easy example, you can say that it is a combination reaction of a substance with oxygen. So here I'm taking a very easy example, that is copper. Copper combines with oxygen. So it will combines with oxygen readily, very fastly when you heat it. When you heat it, and it turns into copper oxide. So this copper has a, when copper metal is fresh means not the corroded one, then this copper has reddish brown surface. So the reddish brown surface of the copper, it will turn into black coating. That means when you heated copper powder in presence of oxygen, then the surface of the copper will coat it with a black substance, and that black substance is the copper oxide foam. The black substance is the copper oxide foam, and here copper combines with oxygen and forms copper oxide. So this is an example of oxidation reaction. This is an example of oxidation reaction. And here, if you are asked that in this reaction, which substance is undergoing oxidation reaction? And your answer is here, copper oxide is not oxidized. I repeat again, here copper oxide is not oxidized. Many of these students got a mistake here, that copper oxide is oxidized. Not copper oxide is oxidized here. Here copper is combined. That means copper is mixed with, or oxygen is added to copper, and forms copper oxide. So here you will say that copper is oxidized. What will you say? Copper is oxidized here. Copper is oxidized and converts into copper oxide. Copper is oxidized here. Then again, the same copper oxide, that means the same copper powder, when you again pass hydrogen gas, that means you take the black substance, copper oxide, and then pass hydrogen gas, heated hydrogen gas, then it will again come to the previous color of the copper, that is the reddish brown surface. You will again obtain the black coating will disappear. Then how is it happen? So when you again pass hydrogen gas, that means when you again allow to react with hydrogen gas, then copper oxide will convert into copper and water. It will convert into copper and water. So here I would like to again continue that in this copper oxide, when it combines with hydrogen, then it again forms to copper and water. So here this copper oxide combines with oxygen. Here copper oxide combines with copper oxide combines with hydrogen and it forms copper and water. So here the substance copper oxide is called reduced. It is reduced. We will say that here copper oxide is reduced to copper in presence of hydrogen, or we can say that hydrogen is added, or hydrogen is react with copper oxide, and this type of reaction where a substance added or mix or react with hydrogen, we call such type of reaction as reduction reaction. Here, this second example is an example of reduction reaction. Then if you observe carefully, if you look carefully, then you can arise me another one more question. That is, ma'am, what happened to this hydrogen gas? This hydrogen, you look at the another product. Oh, you found that this hydrogen combines with oxygen. Yes, obviously, this hydrogen in the reaction combines with oxygen. So as I mentioned you in the above example, if a substance combined with oxygen and form a new product, then that reaction is called oxidation reaction. So here in this same example, hydrogen combines with oxygen and forms water, H2O here, water. That means hydrogen takes place oxidation here, and this copper, it been mixed with or it has been react with hydrogen and it undergoes reduction. That's why this example, in this same example, you have found oxidation part and reduction part. So I will rub this and explain to you again clearly that in this same example, you have found the reduction part, that is copper oxide changes to copper, and again in the same you have again found another type of reaction, that is oxidation part. So such reactions where in a same reaction where reduction and oxidation reactions occur simultaneously is called a redox reaction. It's called a redox reaction. What you call? It's called a redox reaction. So this is an example of redox reaction. And in most of the examples, in most of the reactions, you may found that where oxidation happens, then other substance or other reactant may occur reduction. And then if both oxidation and reduction occurred in the reaction, then that reaction is an example of redox reaction. In higher classes, you will learn about redox reaction and the types, then oxidation and reduction in another more refined way, in another more definitions, in another more definitions. So after I pick up these examples, I would like to explain to you that how can you define an oxidation reaction. Very shortly, you can say that oxidation reaction are those reactions where a substance gains oxygen. You can say this in terms. That means if a substance gains oxygen, then that is a oxidation reaction. Or if a substance loses hydrogen, then that is also a oxidation reaction. And again, another, if a substance or if an atom lose electron, then one electron or two electron, then that also we will go under the heading of oxidation reaction. That means that species, that atoms or that ions undergo oxidation, loss electron. I will pick up an example, very easy example. Suppose your sodium, this, when I write this symbol of sodium, it is a sodium atom. So this sodium atom, it will lose one electron and it will become Na plus, sodium ion, Na plus. So here sodium atoms lose one electron and become sodium ion. This is an example of oxidation. That means sodium atom oxidized to sodium ion. Then further, if another one more electron again lost, then it will become Na2 plus. That means this is also further undergoing oxidation reaction. So such are examples of oxidation reaction. That means the definition of oxidation is not confined only to the gain of oxygen or loss of hydrogen from a substance. It also includes that if a species lose electron, then we consider that process as oxidation. Again, you can define reduction also in that previous easy definition. Reduction, you can say that if a substance gain hydrogen, then you can say that substance undergo reduction. And then if loss oxygen also, then that is also undergoing reduction. The substance undergo reduction, or you can say the substance is reduced. And then if a species gain electron, E minus is the symbol of electron. If a substance or if a species gain space, why I'm saying species, it may be ions, it may be atoms, that's why. So gain electron, then it is undergoing reduction. Easy example, chlorine. So if chlorine gains one electron and it becomes Cl minus, then chlorine atom is undergoing reduction. So we will say that chlorine atom is reduced and it becomes chlorine anions. Then Fe3 plus after gaining one electron, it will become Fe2 plus. This is also an example of reduction reactions. That means these are the definitions of reductions confined to loss of electron and gain of electron. So for oxidation, in terms of in terms of oxidation, in terms of oxidation, it will be in terms of oxidation, oxidation as loss of electron and reduction as gain of electron. This is again a very important definition, and in higher classes you will meet with this type of definitions of oxidation and reduction more. Oxidation, loss of electron, and reduction, gain of electron. Gain of electron to the species, reduction, loss of electron to the species, oxidation. Now, redox reaction. In a redox reaction, you can define as it is a reaction in which one reactant is oxidized while the other gets reduced during a reaction. That means oxidation and reduction will occur simultaneously in the reaction. And that type of reaction we call redox reaction. I will pick up another more interesting example that is very, let us learn from easy one. Here in this zinc oxide, when zinc oxide reacts with carbon, here we will put coke. Coke is a form of carbon. So when zinc oxide reacts with carbon, that means you will heat it, then it will convert into zinc and carbon monoxide. So here, try to find out which one is oxidized and which one is reduced. Here, zinc oxide, the oxidant of zinc oxide loses and convert into zinc. So in terms of loss of oxygen, here you found zinc oxide loss oxygen and becomes zinc. So this is reduction part. And here what you found, carbon. So carbon combines with oxygen and it converts into carbon combines with oxygen and it converts into carbon monoxide. So here carbon converts into carbon monoxide. It is the oxidation part of the reaction. So this is an example of redox reaction. So here you will say that zinc oxide is reduced and carbon is oxidized. Then you can again say that this zinc oxide is the oxidizing agent. Is the oxidizing agent. That means because of this zinc oxide, carbon is able to do oxidation. So zinc oxide is the oxidizing agent. And carbon is the reducing agent. And carbon, you will call carbon as the reducing agent because of presence of this carbon, zinc oxide is able to do reduction. So carbon becomes the reducing agent. Like this, in exams, you are not asked which is oxidized, which is reduced, but very oftenly they ask as a tricky question, which one is the oxidizing agent and which one is the reducing agent. So to answer your questions, you can just find out first which are the reduction part, which are the oxidation part, and then just the opposite are the agents of each other. So because of carbon, it able to do oxidation, sorry, reduction. That's why it is called reducing agent. And because of zinc oxide, carbon is able to do oxidation. So it is the oxidizing agent. That means agent makes happen the thing. In that sense, carbon can do oxidation because of zinc oxide. So that's why zinc oxide become oxidizing agent. And carbon able to do oxidation because of zinc oxide. That's why zinc oxide become oxidizing agent. So like this, you can also discuss more and more examples given to your textbook. And if you have any doubt, any query, you can ask to me at my personal WhatsApp number. That is 9612241606. And I will send this in your class group also, my personal WhatsApp number, so that you can ask me at any time, then I can reply to you. And your exam timing, will be exam timing is 30th of April on Thursday from 11 a.m. to 11:20 a.m. Only 20 minutes and only 10 marks, 10 MCQ question. So that I want to check your knowledge about how far you have studied the types of reactions. Thank you and prepare for your test tomorrow.